Ladies, gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs, meine Damen und Herren, señores y señores. Whoops, sorry. This was surprising. Where were we at? Mesdames et messieurs, welcome back. I am Special Andre. This is the Craft Cup. We are here in round number 7. And who is playing? It is Kaz. And who else is playing? Ukraine Star. Apparently, we have some nice timing in this tournament because this is the third match in a row I will be casting in round number 7. So we saw a lot of best of ones already, and each time the winner of this best of one was able to advance to the quarterfinals of tonight's Craft Cup number 33 with a $100 prize pool. So we got Ukraine Star here spawning at the 9 o'clock position. And next to him is spawning Kaz at the 12 o'clock position. And we are playing on GSL, GSTL Terminus Re. And apparently this map is new in the map pool, because I thought only Testbug was in the map pool. But apparently Kaz said before this game started, oh, this map is in the... he was checking the map pool. He said, okay, it's fine. So apparently this map is now in the map pool as well. And we see Ukraine Star lagging, not anymore. And apparently one other important thing is that, in my personal opinion, this map is one of the most awesomest looking. I really, really like the design, I like the style of this map. And of course I like this small second expansion here with the number 43, and with all those random numbers everywhere. You just need to click somewhere, there we see 21. I just click here, boom, there we see the 31. And just click here, it is the 41. Let's just click here, it is, oh, here's no number. 21, number 3, number, oh, here's no number. So, okay, there are not numbers everywhere, but there are a lot of numbers on this map. And the good thing about this is, if you wall off your front entrance here, you can go for the second expansion right away. But remember, on this expansion, there is only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mineral pitches and one rich Respine Geyser. But this Respine Geyser is a rich one, so you get a couple of more gas out there instead of just 4 each time you harvest a little bit gas out there. So you can very safely play on 3 bases on this map. Of course, if you're moving out to get the third expansion, which most likely will be this here for Ukraine Star, or will be that for Kaz, you're already at the doorstep to your neighbor, and Ukraine Star is pausing the game. Maybe he tries to fix his connection issues, because boost bot breaking. Ah, what does this mean? Any suggestions in the I should check the chat. Ah, next game coming up soon, is it? I am very, very sorry. I am very thankful for the reminder. So, just please hold the line. And in a couple of seconds, we are right back in this game. I am sorry for the delay. And I'm sorry this happens. But I like this life ticker. It was actually it just was there to raise my production value, but some time to times I forget to mute my microphone, or I forget to unmute my microphone, and apparently I'm not forgetting to mute my microphone anymore, but I'm forgetting that I have this. Okay, we got a game coming up very soon as well, but I mean, the good thing about it that it was not here in the big middle of the screen right now, it was only here in the top left, I guess. So but let's focus a little bit on this game. I said we can see a lot of macro going on. We got and this huge reactor thingy here in the middle with the steam coming out of those pipes, and I'm not sure what those valves are good for, but it's just looking awesome here at position number 32, of course, with the operations exclamation mark, danger sign and everything else. So, SCV is moving in, just scouted all those Zerglings, and it's time to retreat. So he just walled off at the top. He does not want to go for any triple barracks mass opening, which is of course not very recommended against the Zerg right here, right there. Of course, Kaz is the best macro Terran I have ever seen next to OGS Nada, but apparently, I was not just yet able to cast some games of another live. I was able to cast some OGS MC, OGS Top, etc. live already, but was not been able to cast another just yet. And from those games I've casted live, I saw a game of Kaz where he was playing against Insolence on the finals of the tournament. And in the end, Kaz had like 8 bases, and Insolence still had 3 bases, and he was just macroing like a crazy person. Insolence played so super cost efficient, but just Kaz macroed him to death. So here we go with the scoreboard right away. There we see Ukraine Star is moving out with his Overlords, checking here at the 43 if there's not an expansion yet, but still. Kaz is on one base, and Zomax is continue to lag, and Zomax should leave the game right away. And if he's... So, let's focus a little bit more on this game. So what is Kaz actually doing? He's going for the Blue Flame Hellions, and he's having a medivac, and he's summoning some marines, and all those marines with the Blue Flame Hellions, because the Blue Flame is finished right now, will of course rip those Zerglings apart. Very good decision by Ukraine Star to go to pull back with his Zerglings. We see the Zerglings took some hits already. One time of the Blue Flame is not enough to kill the Zerglings, but a second flamethrower attack here is just a little too much. So Ukraine Star following it up with a second Spine Quarter, but he's got Kaz got the medivac, so he will be able to drop the marines here on the low ground. He will be able to drop the marines here on the high ground to avoid the spine crawlers. But what is Ukraine Star doing? He's just getting more Zerglings, and this is exactly the thing he should do. He's not having an overload to scout what's going on here on the low ground. Second expansion. Now he's lifting up his remaining forces, and he should be in a pretty good position. So, and there are the forces in the back. There are the Blue Flame Hellions trying to do some damage. But it is enough Zerglings to take out the first two and even the third. Oh no, actually this Hellion was lifted up here by Kaz with 5 HP left. Nice micro there. And the Zerglings are running in again. And now taking out not only the Hellion but a couple of more Marines. But this attack already was worth it. We can take a look at the units lost. And there we see Ukraine Star already lost 30 units worth 1,150 minerals, or resources in general, could also be some gas, even though he only lost Zerglings and a queen. So what is he doing now? Going for a spire. Let's follow those medivac a little bit longer around. And what is this here? Nice scrap station-esque gas station. Here is a broken medivac. Here we have I'm not sure which this aircraft should be, but it is critical mass octane, and it costs 573 bucks, which is quite a lot if you want to get that high quality fuel here. Apparently the farther away you're from home, the more expensive the gas gets, like in the real life. So StarCraft real life, once again, this is, you can learn a lot for your life in StarCraft 2 by watching StarCraft 2. You can learn a lot about different beer brands when you watch Special Andre. And of course you can see me failing it once again, forgetting that I have a life ticker going on while I cast a game or two. But this is not the case anymore, and of course Kaz spotted the Spire, he is aware of it, so his logical follow-up play is to get the missile turrets here in the natural. He has a missile turret in the main, another missile turret is already finished, and he's not only protecting his mineral line, he's protecting his production facilities as well, and this is very, very good, and this is what you need to do. I just now would like him to get another missile turret here. Meanwhile, we have him moving out with the Stimp Marines. What about the screen? The screen needs to run away or it will go down, and looks like the screen will go down in the end. This Spine Crawler is under attack right away, and I'm not really sure if the decision here of Ukraine Star to go for the Judas instead of the Banelings or the Roaches, for the, at least for the beginning of the game, would be a wise one, because now he loses his second queen. Now this Mycroll in the back can deal some damage. Another Muta is out, not yet getting attacked, because there are enough drones and zerglings for the moment to repel those forces. But good job here by Cast to drop the Marines on the low ground. Meanwhile, we do not see a counterattack of any kind coming on right now appearing. And now with the force of the lift up of the Marine, and with having more than actually one Mutalist out, now five in total, he will be able to repel this drop after all. So let's take a look. How much damage did Kaz actually do with this small Marine attack? The harvest account is looking pretty much the same. Ukraine Star hit the second expansion up, but Kaz now going for his third expansion, second expansion, his third base as well, immediately going for the missile turrets, and not only missile turret number one, but missile turret number two as well. Realized, okay, this missile turret at this position wouldn't be the best. He's got his Marines out there to protect this command center in construction. Meanwhile, the missile turrets are still being built. So, Ukraine Star is trying to pick units off somewhere else. He wanted to take down this tank, but the tank still survived. I lost one Muta in the process, killed one Marine there. Now this missile turret there is doing some damage as well, but apparently the remainder of the forces went home, even though pretty much injured. Three in the orange here, one in the red already. And let's take a look at the harvest account once again. Now we see Ukraine Star was able to drone up a little bit more, but he's still behind in supply a slight bit. And now he's finished with his Banelings nest, going for the centrifugal hooks, the Baneling speed upgrade, and he needs to have some Banelings out as soon as possible, because yes, Kaz is now going for an attack once again. He's got the blue flame hellions, he got the Marines, and he also got two siege tank. Even though one siege tank is pretty much injured right now, the siege tank will do a lot of damage. There he's doing a scan, and now Ukraine Star is aware of it with this overlord. Creep tumor goes down, the creep tumor is disappearing here, and with this tank on the high ground, he can attack the low ground expansion, dropping some Marines there, and this aggressive play by Kaz is really paying off quite a lot. The Mutas are not in good enough numbers to take those stunt Marines. He needs to have some Banelings in the mix as well, and with the Banelings he was forcing the lift up, and with the lift up the Mutas could take care of the rest. And I think it is time for Ukraine Star just to wait until those 18 Zerglings and those 5 Banelings and the 4 Mutas are ready, and then go for an attack, because he cannot allow himself to lose this hatchery, and he cannot allow himself Kaz to reinforce with his forces. So now here comes the Zerglings, here roll the Banelings in, nowhere left to run for the Marines, even though he's doing a good spread with his units. It's just not enough, Kaz losing all of his forces. But meanwhile, he just macroed up another a bunch of units where he can go for an attack right away. He's got the plus one for the tanks finished soon, he's got the plus two for the infantry finished soon. And for the moment, Ukraine Star is able to hold off. Let's take a look at the units lost, but there we see what I expected. Kaz is being a little bit more cost-effective, so if Ukraine Star wants to stay at least even, he needs to get another expansion. Maybe here, not that wise, this would be a little bit better of a position, but I would expect him, I would...